It's clear that the Internet of Things offers enormous opportunities, and the Prime Minister is very interested in this and talked about it at the CeBIT Fair in Hanover, and he's asked the Government Office of Science to prepare a report for the government, really to set out the things that government can do. Well, it is actually about analysing what the opportunities of the Internet of Things are, what the vulnerabilities, what some of the security issues are around the Internet of Things as well, because it offers new opportunities for people to do both good things and bad things with the technology. And it's about coming up with recommendations as to how government can catalyse the uptake of the Internet of Things for human benefit and for the benefit of the economy, which of course are closely interlinked.
You see this combination of excitement at technological possibility, but also disappointment with an earlier vision, which one can caricature as a kind of IBM vision of the smart cities, Internet of Things, panopticon. Lots of really exciting projects on mobile labs, data pooling, and a lot around transport and crime, but I think also a sense that they're struggling to find the applications which really do deliver enough value, either commercially or for citizens, and at the very least there's a need for much faster learning about what does or doesn't work, and for some evidence about what does or doesn't work and really does meet needs. And so we need more rounded notions of what the Internet of Things can be, which has at least some place for people in it as well, and some connection to, let's remember, the starting ethos of the Internet itself, which was a liberating ethos. An ethos summed up by Tim Berners-Lee at the London Olympics, you know, this is for everyone. This is not just something imposed on people from on top.
But there's a few questions we should ask, which I'm sure you'll ask all day. Who's in charge? Yeah. There's lots of companies, a couple here, Smart Things, another one, trying to be that dashboard. And nobody's really discussing if there is one Amazon controlling the book trade, you know, will there be one company controlling the network? We talked about the vulnerability, but I think this is one of our biggest questions at the moment. This report on spam emails launched from the legendary internet fridge and television, and pretty much anything that's on the network has vulnerability.
I think there's a lot of challenges for Internet of Things at the moment in really achieving the large rollout and therefore the value in scale that it promises. Energy is a big one. You know, you can't change batteries on this huge array of stuff. It's already enough of being changing batteries on the things you have in your house and so on. So energy harvesting, I think, is a really interesting space. And the convergence between energy harvesting on one side and also low and low power radios and processing and devices on the other side. That will be interesting where those intersect.
What we think is needed is a simple, low-cost, sensor-to-cloud, wide-area connectivity technology with features that look like very, very long battery life. You can put this technology in a module and it can last for maybe up to 20 years, depending on duty cycle, on just a couple of AAA batteries. It's low cost, so no standards essential patent royalties on it. Means the module cost has to be around about $3, so about £2 per module. Small printed antenna, a couple of AA batteries, sort of £4, we're done, it's in there, and it'll work essentially anywhere. The first thing that's needed on spectrum, it's got to be harmonized. There's no point in every country having a slightly different use of spectrum. The cost of the hardware is going to be ridiculously expensive. It would be impossible for any consumer electronics company to put it in a product and know it'll work globally. So harmonization is essential, really, for the use of spectrum.
The government's role is to be catalytic. It is actually to create the policies in which this new technology can thrive, and it's about looking to the future and working out how we maximise the benefit and minimise the risks. It's about ensuring that the standards are fit for purpose so that one can get the maximum interoperability. It's about thinking about the security issues and the vulnerabilities that are associated with the Internet of Things. One of the key things is to establish a clear vision of what the Internet of Things is all about. And actually, it's about delivering services more effectively. It's about using resources more efficiently. So the opportunities are absolutely extraordinary.
We're talking about the Internet of Things, but I want to talk about the Web of Things. So often there's this question of or a lot of focus when there's a dialogue about the Internet of Things on how stuff actually gets connected to the internet, if you like, the hardware layer of the stack. But there's a second question, which is how do applications connect with things? Because if we really want to create value from things, then we need to be concerned about how the data from those objects connects with applications. You know, technologically, our point of view is that physical things should be as discoverable on the web as digital things are today. Bruce Sterling said, why can't I Google my shoes? Now, to realize that kind of environment, it means that we need to give physical things at the same level of identity on the web that digital assets have. Why can't we mash up my shoes along with my Flickr images? So the technology behind this is what we call active digital identities, but essentially it's web objects representing physical objects.
As everybody here knows, you can design the technology and it will stay on the shelf until a second thing happens, which is you need the right business model to liberate that technology and get people using it. And in some cases with Internet of Things, the business model will be driven by business. There'll be B2B applications that mean that they can manage their logistics more effectively and so on and so forth. And in some cases, there will be consumer-driven interests. I think wearables will, because I mean, wearables, they're a bit anecdotal, but actually most people will think they're cool and sexy and they'll want wearables. I think that the consumers will drive that. And there will be areas where government could drive it. One of the things that will help drive some of this is the ability sensibly to monetize data. Nowhere in the world so far is there a proper framework that will develop consumer trust in that. And that will be a huge opportunity for the UK to lead the world if we got it right.
We also need to make progress, I think, in data analytics in order to make really sense of all the information that we can collect. For example, from the point of view of sensors, which is of course a very important field for Bosch as a major producer of sensors in many fields, the aspect of reducing power consumption of these sensors is key to making them a useful component for the Internet of Things.